here to talk about the Originators, which is part of the Cultural Investment Programme, which funds arts organisations, artists, events and festivals in the city. And the team that support that are the Arts and Events team. And I manage the Arts and Events team. And Melissa Inman, who will be here later, manages the Events team. And we're an incredibly small but brilliantly ambitious team. And we're doing everything we can to make sure that we support artists and creatives in the city to do what they do best, which is being innovative, creative, and make excellent work. So the funding, it's really important to remember that the funding is directly funded by Bristol citizens, which includes you, if you live in the city, but we need to make sure that the funds go are of benefit of Bristol citizens, and so they are paying for it. But we need to make sure that we do it in a really transparent way. And our overarching aim is about making arts and culture accessible to all in the city. So I'm going to talk about the aims and objectives, but before that, I wanted to talk about something, a few things to do with your application or a project that you're thinking about, or thinking about yourself as an artist or an organization. Really important before you apply to understand what your core values are. Be clear about what you want your impact to be, whether you're applying for our funding or any funding you're applying for. Because the clearer you are from before you apply, the clearer it's going to become throughout the application process. But if you're trying to work that out while you're applying, then it's, you know, you're going to be sort of fitting to our criteria and what our aims are for the fund. And so it's better to understand what your why is, why you're doing it, and how you want to do it, and what impact that's going to have before you apply, so you can be clearer. And I think you'll use less of your time if you're clear about that before you approach the application. I need to think about your work being accessible. And this fund particularly focuses on communities, and again, going back to always, making arts and culture accessible to all. So you can apply for up to £5,000 for this fund. We spent a lot of time writing the guidance notes to be as helpful as we can to you. There's lots of questions in the guidance notes to prompt you to be answering the questions in the right way, and also help to guide you on which aims or objectives are most appropriate for your project. So read the guidance notes lots and lots of times before you sit down and start writing anything down about, you know, the application, because it will help. It will bring that kind of clarity of what you want your project to be. And as you go through and you start writing the application, it might be that what you're writing down doesn't fit that objective, and you can change it. And also think about partnerships. I always feel like we succeed when we work together. And actually, partnership, we're really interested in partnership working in the city and how we put together community organisations with artists and arts organisations, and how can we grow the making arts and culture accessible to all through partnerships. So the more partnership working, and the more that partnership is established before the project starts, the better. Because then they can be involved in the application, and then you'll have that real partnership, the solid partnership before you start. Ask us questions when you're writing your application. We're really open to answer any questions, and also any questions that we're asked, we will anonymously put out to everyone else to understand those questions too, because we quite often get similar questions but in a different way. So they might be that we've already been answered the question that you're asking, and we can help you with that. So you can, if you've already applied before, you can apply for a repeat project. But you need to show how it's developed. You need to show how learning from your previous project has gone into the new project, and how you might be working with new partners, or how that partnership might be more solid, and thinking about how you're going to get other funding in to support that project. Also, the partnership can be outside of Bristol, but the main applicant, the lead applicant, has to be based in Bristol, because, again, going back to where the funding's from, it's from people of Bristol, so we need to make sure that the money goes to them. And I understand that everyone's artists in the room, and creatives are also Bristol citizens, so you benefit from it too. I'm going to move on to the aims. So the key aims of our funding is to develop Bristol's reputation, as a leading cultural city. We already are a leading cultural city, but how can we do that even better? And how can we advance diversity and equality in arts and culture? And how can we support the delivery of Bristol City Council's corporate strategy? That's a bit jargony, probably that last one's a bit jargony, but in the corporate strategy, there's a lot that talks about supporting businesses, being inclusive, making sure everyone in the city has a chance, has a voice, and is part of what we're moving towards as a relevant and brilliant city. So that changes quite often, but if you're really interested, you can read the corporate strategy. But moving on to, so when you're applying for originators, we only ask that you answer one of the objectives under each aim. So that's why I'm saying think really carefully about the objective that you choose to answer. And as you can see up here, they're linked to lots of different things. So for instance, it could be that you're at a point in your organisation where you want to think about how resilient you are, and then if you want to grow as an organisation, you might want to become a charity, or you might want to think about, you might be an individual artist, so you might think about working with someone else and grow your practice. Or you might be really early stages of your career, and you can see that to move forward in your career, to do the next project, you need to apply for some money to help you that, or a project that's going to help you develop that. So it's a lot about resilience. And in the past, our funding wouldn't necessarily pay for development, but we've realised that actually, to succeed, the sector needs to have the infrastructure as support and think about how you're going to grow. So we've added that made it easier for you to apply for that. Or it might be that you've got a really amazing, innovative idea that's never been done before, that's really important for the city, and you want to share it and grow it. In which case you can apply for that. So, think really carefully about which objective you use. Or it could be that you're working with people around, you could be working with a collection of young people to think about what their career is going to be and help them build their practice and their career. And you could be focusing, and then you could pick the development and learning career pathways. In the guidance, there's loads of pointers and questions that help with each objective to help you think about how you can target how you best answer the objectives. So in aim two, it's focused around advancing diversity and equality. And you've probably noticed that's one of the themes that runs through all of what I'm saying, is around equality and inclusivity. We'll be asking you what your project is, at the beginning, what your project is, and so you need to be really clear about what you're doing and why you're doing it. But it might be you're doing a project and you haven't necessarily considered barriers to the work or access to your workshops, and it could be that one of your objectives is around that. It's like, I've got a really great practice, I'm doing a really great project, but how can I open this up to as many people as possible? And so an aspect of your project might focus on that. Or it might focus on working more with volunteers, thinking about how you open up your work and create opportunities for volunteers. And thinking about how your work might support the rest of the cultural sector. So it's really important, again, to remember you only have to answer one objective per aim, one. If you answer more, it'll be really difficult for us because we can only answer one. And when I talk about, and when I say about which objective you choose, we have a really clear scoring matrix for each of the objectives. And so you can't assume that we've read the rest of the other bits of the application are necessarily going to impact on what you've written any under each objective. So we're scoring that in isolation. We do consider other elements of the application when we're scoring it at the end. But again, use your text really wisely, and go through and make sure you don't repeat yourself. I'm saying this because I've read, assessed quite a lot of applications, and you see repetition, and it's just so frustrating because you can see a brilliant project actually, and that you could have expanded on more, but you know, we don't necessarily see the full picture. So objective aim three, which is around the corporate strategy. So that breaks down into health and well-being through arts and culture. Thinking about, again, priority groups. In the guidance, there's a description of priority groups that will help you in areas in which not as much cultural activity happens. And so there, those areas we do prioritise. So, so there's a different, there's a spread across the city of cultural activity. Culture happens everywhere. But in places where we want to fund activity where we haven't necessarily funded activity before. So you can do something that's really small and targeted, but you can also do something citywide. So in terms of the facts, the lowest amount we gave last time was 1,800. The largest amount was the full amount, 5,000, and the average amount was 4,672. And we had 30 applications and we funded 15, which is a really good success rate. Normally, funding success rate is around 15-20%. So, but again, it depends how many applications we get. So in terms of scoring and assessment, your applications are scored by a minimum of 2 officers. And we get expertise from different areas within the council, from a qualities team, finance and business. And so we have a really fair and robust process. This is the example of what we use for our scoring matrix. We have a question and then we score it. We give it a score between 0 and 3. Again, you can see this in the guidance notes. And then we also have a balancing score, which looks at how accessible the project is for Bristol residents, and the type of activity and kind of cultural spread across the city, and the level of how much you're asking for and how much impact there's going to be. But I quickly wanted to talk to you about budgets. You can apply for 100% of your project, which your form so changed, because you realise that when you're at this stage, it's really difficult. Actually, you just need something to get started. But we do like to see in kind, so if you're working with an organisation, a bigger organisation in the city, and you say, actually, can I use your space? Hopefully they'll say yes. And that is in kind support. So you need to get a value from them for that. Or it might be that you talk to a friend who's an expert or something. Actually, they're giving you something of value. So you can also put that in kind. We've got a template that you can use for your budget in. Please use it. And please put a contingency in your budget. And if you get match money, if you do actually get additional cash, then brilliant. You need to be really clear about whether it's the funding is confirmed, likely, or unconfirmed, so that we can gauge how solid that is. Pay yourselves properly, please. And pay people that you're working with properly. Because we're a team of project managers and artists, we understand how much you should be paid and how much you should pay other people. And we won't fund projects that don't pay people properly. I think we mentioned it in our guidance about payment. So make sure you pay yourself properly. And evaluation. So we talk about that in the guidance notes. And basically, you kind of set your own criteria at the beginning of the project. If you say you're going to work with 200 people, then that's what we will imagine that you're going to do. So we'll be looking at the report and at your application and balancing that and seeing how successful you've been. Also, we understand that by funding projects, we're taking a risk, and that you're taking a risk, and you're doing something creative and brilliant. It's not always going to work. But as long as you tell us why it hasn't worked and what you might do differently, that's okay too. So yeah, I'm way over my time. So thank you so much for listening to me. And I'm really excited to get the applications in and see what brilliant things you're doing in the city, what brilliant things you're proposing to do in the city. And keep on asking us questions and make sure you get as much from our team as you can. If you have any questions throughout the application process, just ask us and we can do our best to help. The deadline is the 15th of November, midday. The deadline for questions is the 8th of November. So we make sure that everyone's got enough time to read all the questions that have come in, and then we have a week before we close.